Hi, let's talk about the intrinsic laryngeal membranes. In this video, we'll discuss the intrinsic laryngeal membranes, specifically the quadrangular membranes and Conus elasticus, detailing their constituent parts and explaining their functional and clinical significances. So, the quadrangular membranes are a pair of membranes, left and right, that sit at the superior aspect of the larynx. They have two constituent parts. There are the airy epiglottic ligaments. The airy epiglottic ligaments are named for their attachments. So they run from the arytenoid cartilage to the epiglottic cartilage, and there is one on each side. When invested with mucosa, these are the airy epiglottic folds, which we can see illustrated there, making up the lateral aspect of the laryngeal inlet. The inferiormost or free edge of the quadrangular membranes are the vestibular ligaments. The vestibular ligaments run from the arytenoid cartilage out to the thyroid cartilage, like so. So if we can imagine, all of this space would be a quadrangular membrane. And on the other side, we would have another quadrangular membrane. Now that vestibular ligament, when invested by mucosa, becomes the vestibular fold or the false vocal fold. It has a protective function over the larynx and it can produce sound. So if you think of throat singing or that sound of aww, that is vibration of the vestibular ligaments, but it is not phonation. Also, the space between the vestibular ligaments is known as the rima vestibuli. The function in totality of the quadrangular membranes is to direct air in through the laryngeal vestibule. So this is an inward movement of air. We can contrast that with the conus elasticus, which is a single membrane with several constituent parts. It's oftentimes referred to as the cricothyroid membrane, but it is so much more than that. So the three parts are the lateral cricothyroid ligaments, which are located there. The median cricothyroid ligament, which is located there. There's the other lateral cricothyroid ligament. And then its superiormost part, the vocal ligament, which, as you may recall, runs from the vocal process of the arytenoid cartilage to the thyroid cartilage. When invested by mucosa, the vocal ligament is the vocal fold, aka the vocal cord. Now, the conus elasticus directs air out through the larynx, specifically toward the space between the vocal folds called the rima glottidis. Now, it's that rima glottidis that is going to expand as the vocal folds abduct or narrow as they adduct. Now, for breathing purposes, for ventilation, the fold should be maximally abducted or open. For phonation, those folds need to be not tight against one another, but in relative close proximity so that those folds can vibrate for phonation. Now, let's take a look at this space in a little larger sense. So there's our airy epiglottic ligament and fold. There's our vestibular ligament and fold. So there's a quadrangular membrane on one side. Here is the lateral cricothyroid and the medial cricothyroid, and then the vocal ligament. The space between these two is known as the laryngeal ventricle. And then the spaces above the laryngeal ventricle are the rima vestibuli, and below the rima glottidis. And then below that would be the infraglottic cavity. So we can see these relative relationships between quadrangular membranes and the conus elasticus. One last thing to discuss is the Median cricothyroid ligaments important for a cricothyrotomy. Cricothyrotomy is the incision of that median cricothyroid ligament. And it's done under emergent situations if one needs airway access. There are very good anatomical landmarks that are palpatable. So you can feel for the laryngeal prominence. If you run your finger inferior from that laryngeal prominence, you'll encounter a divot. That's the median cricothyroid ligament. And then just below that is another solid structure. And one incises the skin and then perforates that median cricothyroid ligament, and we have an airway. What's nice about this is that there are no major vascular issues lying superficial to this, and there are good palpatable landmarks. Now, this is only for emergency uses only. It's not meant for long-term airway management. So we've discussed the various intrinsic membranes of the laryngoskeleton and their constituent parts, how they hold together various elements of the laryngoskeleton, and how they regulate the movement of air. This is your summary slide, and I thank you for your time.